I'm glad to see you're still with us. How can I help you? I appreciate it. Well, that's it. This is all we need. Now all that's left is to quietly pack up and try to get out of here without being noticed. That's assuming that Joshua won't try to stop me. And that he hasn't talked you into fighting the Whitelegs despite what I've said. Don't worry, I don't hold it against you. You're an outsider. Fighting seems like the practical solution. I'll tell you again, there's more at stake. Even our Lord had doubts. Think it over, but listen to your heart. And do it quickly. We don't have much time.
Please be respectful here. These are the bones of our ancestors. Under control. You leave me no choice. I have this under control. Stay cautious. You could have met my family. You would like them, I think.
Unless you and Joshua have any objections, I'd like to start evacuating the Saros. I'm going to need your help, so say your piece. No. Why? Why? Haven't you seen enough of what's going on here to see that the Saros don't need to butcher the Whitelegs for a piece of land? What Joshua wants is more than an attack. He wants a slaughter. And he needs more than you and the dead horses to do it. The Saros can't be pushed into this. You and Joshua don't have the right to force them into it. Please, consider what I'm saying. No. This is how we made it. And we brought it to them. Joshua must be waiting for you. I'll stay here with the others.
Thank you for this. I know Daniel doesn't approve, but destroying the Whitelegs is the only way to ensure the Saros can remain in Zion. You and I will lead a group of Dead Horse warriors and Saros hunters into Three Marys from this position. Our objective is to find the Whitelegs' leader, Salt Upon Wounds, and prevent him from fleeing. Show no quarter to the Whitelegs we come across. Make no mistake about why we are here. This is an extermination. God be with you.
Thank you. Oladu Sagasi.
Oladu Sagasi. The time for talk has passed. The Lord's work must be done. This is taking too long. We can't let salt upon wounds escape. I'm going to find a way around. God willing, we will finish this together. warned you at Syracuse, and you persisted. You took advantage of us at New Canaan to drive us out. And like the dogs of Caesar you are, you followed us to Zion. And now you stand on holy ground, a temple to God's glory on earth. The only use for an animal in our temple is sacrifice. Kale Wachene Conserva O. You understand me, don't you? Don't you?
Outman. Kunaman, mad. He kill all white legs. You talk. You stop. Him hear you. You talk.
Don't listen to this thing. His cries are those of a mad beast caught in a thicket. He gave no mercy to my family, and I will give none to his. He never had any dignity to begin with. None of them did. But for your sake, for the sorrow's sake, I'll let him die on his feet. Stand up and look at what's come for you. It's the same end he would have met if he had died on his knees. But I suppose this was for the sake of the dead horses and sorrows. Still, thanks to your help and the grace of God, the White Legs won't be troubling Zion anymore. Let's go find Daniel. Tomorrow we'll be here soon enough, and there is much to do.
And so it was that the conflict between the New Canaanites and the White Legs was finally resolved. The courier's involvement had tipped the scale, shifting the fragile balance of power.
Despite their defeat at Three Marys, and the death of their war chief, the White Legs were determined to pursue the other New Canaanites. But when they finally tracked down their prey in Colorado, they discovered the tables had been turned. The White Legs who survived the New Canaanites' ambushes were hunted down by dead horses before they could reach the safety of the Great Salt Lake. When word of the White Legs' diminished numbers reached the 80s tribe, war was declared. And by year's end, the White Legs had been wiped out.
The Sorrows fought beside Joshua Graham and the dead horses, eradicating the threat the White Legs posed to Zion. When the courier and Joshua Graham felled Salt Upon Moons, their victory was celebrated with a great feast. The Sorrows' transformation from a peaceful, timid tribe into a proud and warlike people broke Daniel's heart. He tried to take solace in the knowledge that they would remain in Zion, but it was a small comfort. The Sorrow's innocence was lost.
Having helped eradicate the White Legs from Zion, the dead horses returned to Dead Horse Point in triumph. They remained neutral toward the Sorrows, but as years went on, there were periods of competitive friction, even violence between the tribes. The New Canaanites, Daniel especially, intervened regularly as mediators, but found it difficult to reconcile the tribes' conflicts.
The defeat of the White Legs in Zion marked a turning point in the fortunes of the Happy Trails Caravan Company. Every 2 months, the caravan met with the New Canaanites in Zion Valley to trade. Happy Trails soon returned to prosperity. The vigilance of the Sorrows and dead horses in defending southwestern Utah, initially startling to Happy Trails caravans, soon proved a blessing. The tribes united against the 80s, driving them back from Highway 50, and thus opening yet another trading route for Happy Trails caravans.
Waking Cloud was distraught when she learned of her husband's death, but took comfort from her tribe and the compassion of the New Canaanites. She forgave Daniel for having concealed her husband's fate from her, and learned to accept his fate. When her grief faded, She took a husband from the Dead Horse tribe. At her bidding, he stayed close to home.
Though the courier had stopped Joshua Graham from executing Salt Upon Wounds, the war chief still fell in battle. The White Legs defeated at Three Marys. Joshua led the Sorrows and Dead Horses in tending to their comrades and burning the corpses of their foes. He continued to advocate militant opposition to the enemies of New Canaan and showed little quarter to those he fought. And yet he was changed. He no longer reveled in the brutality and cruelty for which he had been known in his former life. His inner demons, if not extinguished, were at the least appeased.
For years after the defeat of the White Legs, Daniel did his best to minister to the Sorrows' spiritual needs. Try as he might, he could not hold back the tribe's increasing militancy and reverence of Joshua Graham. Demoralized, he returned to his family and Dead Horse Point. His failures haunted him for the rest of his days.
And with that, the courier walked out of the history of the tribes of Zion and back to the gathering storm of the Mojave Wasteland.